Hello friends, good morning. Welcome to our chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss about most interesting and important terms, friends. Okay friends, let us start. First, chemoselectivity. Next, I'll discuss about regioselectivity, followed by stereoselectivity and stereospecificity. Okay friends, let us see. First, chemoselectivity. See, chemoselectivity means it is the ability of reagent or intermediate to react with one group or atom in a molecule in preference to another group or atom present in the same molecule. See friends, chemoselectivity means actually this is the ability of the reagent. Okay, ability of the reagent to react with one group or atom. See, this is the molecule, no? Okay, in this molecule, if we observe, here two groups are present. Okay, two groups, hydroxyl groups and amine groups. So here chemoselectivity means ability of the reagent, okay, ability of the reagent or intermediate to react with, okay, with the group, sorry, to react with which group, because here two groups are present, no? So here the ability of the reagent, okay, to select, okay, or to react with one group or atom in a molecule, okay, in preference to another group. Okay, see, in between these two groups, this reagent or intermediate will definitely have to prefer or select one group, okay, which is present in the molecule. Okay, this is called chemoselectivity. Okay, hope you understood the definition for this. Okay, let us apply this in this. Okay, see, first, this is para-aminophenol. Okay, para-aminophenol. Here, this is excess of acetic anhydride. Okay, yeah, at 100 degrees centigrade, toluene. Okay, and reflux. Okay, here reflux means heat. Okay, I think you have idea about this. See, here we are taking this reagent in excess amount. Okay, see, as here we are using the excess amount of reagent. Okay, no need to worry or no need of selection, friends. Okay, see, just means here in case of means this one, this reagent can react, okay, can react with both the groups present within this molecules, because here we have taken excess of acetic anhydride. Okay, that's why, see, in both cases, see, here also, okay, means in both the cases here we got, means here we got the product. Means how we got the product means here we have taken excess of acetic anhydride, so that here the reagent has reacted with both the groups present within this molecule. Okay, so this is one case, friends. Next, let us see the second case. See, here we have taken excess of reagent, but here, see, in this case, here we are taking only one equivalent. Okay, remember this. Here we are taking only one equivalent of acetic anhydride. Okay, here we have taken pyridine, so we can say that this is under basic condition. Okay, see, this point is important, friends. Here we have taken only one equivalent acetic anhydride. Okay, so here chemoselectivity will definitely works, because here our reagent is only in one equivalent amount, so that our reagent have to prefer. Okay, means here two groups are present, no? So among these, means in between these two groups, our reagent have to prefer one group and it has to react with that one group. Okay, see, here hydroxyl groups and amine groups both are present, no? Okay, here we have taken pyridine. Pyridine means basic medium. So this, okay, this reagent prefers to react with the basic amine group. Okay, okay, so means here in between these two, our reagent have preferred this one, amine group. So this kind of selection is called chemoselectivity. Okay, so here paracetamol is formed, friends. This is paracetamol. Okay, hope you understood about the chemoselectivity. Okay, next, see, regioselectivity. Okay, regioselectivity. Regio means region, friends. Okay, see, regioselectivity. See, if one product is favored over other, or preference of chemical bonding or breaking in one direction over all other possible directions. See, simply regioselectivity means in some reactions, means if we absorb the product, we used to tell that one product is major and another product is minor, like that we used to tell, no? So like that means if one product is favored over the other, or one product is said to be major when compared to the other. So this phenomenon of selecting one product and telling that particular product as major is nothing but the regioselectivity. Okay, we can also say the definition like preference of chemical bonding or breaking in one direction over all other possible directions. Means here so many directions may be possible, okay, but here we are selecting only one direction. So preference of chemical bonding or breaking in one direction over all other possible directions is called regioselectivity. See friends, try to observe this. See here, see, in the presence of NBS, NBS means what? N-bromosuccinamide, okay, 95% acetone, okay, actually these are the byproducts friends, okay, and this is said to be major, okay, means it may be formed in more amount, okay. Okay, this is said to be major and this is said to be minor, okay. How we are able to tell this particular, this product as major and this as minor, okay. Okay, that one I'll explain now, but before that we want to know exactly about the regioselectivity, okay. Regioselectivity means just means favoring or preferring or the selection of one product as major and another product as minor. This phenomenon is called regioselectivity, okay. Let us apply this regioselectivity by taking one example, okay. See regioselectivity, selecting the major product among other products, okay. We may have so many products, but among those products, selecting the major product, that is regioselectivity. See friends, try to observe this. See, in N-bromosuccinamide, you know, this bromine cation, or we can also say like bromonium cation, like that we can say, okay. See, here we have two chances friends, two cases, okay. If the double bond moves towards this carbon, see, try to focus on this, see. If this double bond moves towards this carbon, means this carbon will definitely get the negative charge, okay, and this carbon will get the positive charge, okay. This is the first case friends, okay. Here I have represented A, okay. A means first case. See, in the first case, this double bond, okay, this double bond will shift towards this side, okay. As this double bond is moving towards this side, here we will get negative charge, okay, and this carbon will get positive charge, okay. Here we got negative charge, no? So our bromonium cation will definitely get attached at this position, because already here we have a negative charge, no? So this positively charged bromonium cation will get attached at this position. See friends, the same thing here I have mentioned, okay. See, here we got the negative charge because the double bond shifted towards this side, no? So that this bromonium, okay, this bromine will get attached at this position, okay. And here the double bond, as usual friends, okay. See, next, second case, this is the second case friends, and here I have mentioned this as B, okay. See, in the second case, the double bond moved towards this carbon, okay. As the double bond is moving towards this carbon will get negative charge, okay. This carbon will get negative charge, and see, this carbon will get positive charge, okay. This carbon will get positive charge. So see, the same thing here I have represented friends, okay. As this double bond is moving towards this carbon, here we have to mention negative charge, okay. Yeah, so here we will have the negative charge, okay. As the negative charge is present, the bromine which is positively charged will get an attack at this position, okay. Yeah, now see, now we have to, of course, on further reaction we will get this, but up to here our means the thing actually what we had to understand means among these two products we are able to tell that one product is said to be major, okay, another product is said to be minor. Now how we are able to differentiate that one I want to tell you now, okay. See, If we observe this positive charge, okay, see, this positively charged carbocation is tertiary in nature because, see, if we observe, this carbocation is attached to three carbons, okay, 1, 2, 3. So, we can say that this is tertiary carbocation. We know that tertiary carbocation is stable, so it is said to be major, okay. See, in this case, if we observe the carbocation, okay, so to this carbocation, only one carbon is attached. That means it is primary carbocation, okay. We know that order of carbocation, we have idea, no? So, tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary carbocation. Secondary carbocation is more stable than primary carbocation, okay. As this is tertiary, this is more stable. So, we can say it as major, okay. And this is minor. So, it is said to be least stable, okay. This is regioselectivity, friends. Hope you understood about regioselectivity, okay. Next, stereoselectivity, okay. Stereoselectivity. Stereoselectivity means how to react, okay. How to react. Selection among the stereomers, stereoisomers. See, stereoselectivity means selection among the stereoisomers, okay. Preferentially producing a particular stereoisomeric form of the product, irrespective of configuration of the reactant. This point is very important, friends, okay. In case of stereoselectivity, of course, here one product is formed, means particular stereoisomeric form of the product is preferential or selected, okay. But here the product is, means here the product does not depends upon the configuration of the reactant. This point is important, friends, okay. See, preferentially producing a particular stereoisomeric form of the product, okay, irrespective of configuration of the reactant. So here the product which is formed does not depends upon the configuration of the reactant, okay. Next, see, we can also say like, see, the process is one in which one stereomer predominates over another, okay, over another when two or more products may be formed, okay. Means when two or more stereoisomeric products are formed, then among those one stereoisomer predominates over other, no. So this process, so the process in which one stereoisomer predominates over another when two or more products be formed, okay. That thing. Next, if the products are enantiomers, the reaction is said to be enantioselective. So, in case of this stereoselectivity only, we have two kinds, okay. That is enantioselective and diastereoselective, okay. If the products are enantiomers, means the reaction is said to be enantioselective, okay. If, see, if the products are diastereomers, means the reaction is said to be diastereoselective, okay. Next, see. An example of modest stereoselectivity is the dehydrogenation of 2-hydrobutene, okay, which yields 60% trans-2-butene and 20% cis-2-butene. So, we know that cis-2-butene and trans-2-butene, both are what? Stereoisomers. So, it between these two stereomers, okay, one is, means preferentially, one stereoisomeric form of the product is produced, no? So, this thing, okay. Since alkene geometric isomers are also classified as diastereomers. See, means here we are taking iodobutane, no? See, here I have mentioned butene, friends. Okay, see, this one, friends. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, means 2-iodobutane, okay? 2-iodobutane. See, if we observe the product, see, these, okay, these are what? Stereoisomers, okay? This is transbutene and this is cisbutene. So, these are the stereoisomers. But here one is formed in 60%. So, the percentage contribution or the percentage which is formed in more amount is this one. So, trans. Okay. 60% trans and 20% cis. Okay. So, we can simply say that, see, preferentially producing a particular stereomeric form of the product, irrespective of the configuration of the reactant, okay. See, here, see, one stereoisomer predominates over the another, means, see, in the example which we have taken, their transbutene, okay, transbutene predominates over the another, no. So, So that thing, that is stereoselectivity. Okay. So yes, stereoselectivity. Next friends, stereospecificity. Okay. Stereospecificity. Stereospecificity means this thing depended upon the stereochemistry of the reactant. Okay. See, in this case means this is stereoselectivity. Here it is independent of the configuration of the reactant. But in case of the stereospecificity, it is dependent upon the stereochemistry of the reactant or the starting material. Okay. If the reactant means, if the stereochemistry of the reactant is cis means, then the product, okay, then the product must be cis. Okay. If the reactant is trans means the product must be trans. So this is stereospecificity. See here, okay, this is, see, this is cisbutene, no? Yeah, cisbutene. So in presence of metachloroperbenzoic acid, of course you may take anything friends. Okay, here we have taken metachloroperbenzoic acid and osmium tetroxide. Okay, the thing what we have to absorb is reactant. Okay, here the reactant is cis, so the product must be cis. So cis, so in this case also we got cis. So this is stereospecificity. Okay, next, see, here we have taken transbutene. So as here we have taken the trans, the products are also, okay, is in, means the product must be in trans. See here, trans. Okay, the same thing in this case also. So here just what we had to remember is stereospecificity totally depends upon the, okay, reactant. Okay, if the reactant is cis means the product must be cis, and if the reactant is trans means the product must be trans. Okay, I want to tell this once again friends. See, chemoselectivity. Okay, chemoselectivity means, okay, ability of the reagent, okay, ability of the reagent to react with one group or other group in a molecule. Okay, so just selecting, or the, we can say that preferring or selecting the atoms or the groups present in a molecule, that is chemoselectivity. Okay, next, regioselectivity means just, okay, means identifying whether, means which product is major or which product is minor. So just based on the stability, okay, we can find, we can find this, no? So this is regioselectivity. Okay, major or minor, that thing we can tell by using this, that is regioselectivity. Okay, stereoselectivity means this percentage is from 60%, 20%, that thing means, see, stereoisomer means one stereoisomer predominates over another, no? So this thing can be told based on the stereoselectivity. Finally, stereospecificity. So it is totally dependent on the, okay, stereochemistry of the reactant. Okay, stereo, in case of stereoselectivity, that is independent on the reactant, but it's quite opposite. Okay, in case of stereospecificity, the stereochemistry of the, means here it is totally depends on the stereochemistry of the reactant. Okay, if the reactant is cis means the product must be cis, if the reactant is in trans condition means the product must be trans. Okay, hope you understood about this friends. Thank you.